I must be crazy for trying this.
Hey YouTube, Raul here. Now, obviously that's not me, right? If you're an air gunner, you know who that is. And we're really not here to talk about Ted. What we're actually going to be talking about on this video is that, or specifically, the Scopecam bracket that he's using on his camera. Now, that looks to be a very sturdy device, and a gentleman in England apparently was the one who built that for him. So, I asked myself, if I can't get it and buy it here, then I'm going to have to make it. How do I go about making it? So, that's basically the topic of this video. I have the parts, which are, we have the sunshade, which basically comes from the Hawke Sidewinder 30 that I have. I don't use it at all, so I'm going to use it as one of the main components. And the beautiful thing about the Sidewinder Hawke scopes is they come with these aluminum caps that screw on there. So basically I'm going to drill all this out, and if you can see, I've already marked it out. All along the line is where I'm going to drill out to pop this off. This is actually going to be glued onto that camera, and this one is going to screw onto the actual Hawke scope. Now with this project, you must understand that unless you're willing to risk destroying these pieces, which are not really available anymore through the Hawke's optic website. I mean, this is, from what I can tell, you only get them, especially these, with the scope. I haven't found them as aftermarket parts. So unless you're willing to destroy these and ruining them, I'd advise you also not to do this project yourself. Also, I'm running a great risk of destroying that camera, because this part is basically going to be glued on there. And I'll be showing you the process as we go.
The original plan was to use the background noise for this video, but that would have set off a copyright strike on YouTube, so we're gonna scratch that idea. We're gonna do a voiceover. Now, as you can see, I don't specifically remember the drill bit that I chose for this. I just went with the smallest one I could find that would not damage the smaller of the two caps that I use for the creation of this mount. Obviously use whatever tools are available to you if you want to make your own mount. I would recommend, if you have a drill press, use it, or a pneumatic wheel metal cutter. I didn't show it, but I used it quite a bit for the larger one. On the little one, I just used the drill bit and some pliers, some cutters. That was all. The smaller one was actually the fastest of the two caps. You know, it went by quick. I was able to finish that one quick. Now, I'm not going to talk a lot. I'm probably actually going to use some music from YouTube that's free and will not set off a strike. But video editing is I used it quite a bit on this video. Originally this video was like 50 minutes long. It was huge, boring. Cut it down to 15. Hopefully it's more tolerable watching it this way. But as you can see, it took me quite a bit on that first cap. I was learning through the whole process of what I could use. You know, I had a complete automotive shop and all their tools at my disposal, but I didn't have a clue what I would use to not destroy the caps. I had to take my time, try not to overheat the metal, and trying to stay within the lines and try not to blow, you know, a hole in one of my fingers or whatnot. But again, if you approach the setup yourselves, you know, you can learn from my mistakes, you know, learn from what I'm doing. You don't necessarily need this big sunshade, you know, you could, or if you don't even have a sunshade with the caps, you know, you could actually just buy the sunshade off of like Pyramid Air, which is where I bought mine, or the smaller one. It was a 40 millimeter UTG sunshade. It turns out that would have actually worked perfectly for the main sunshade that glues onto the camera. It was 50 millimeters at its biggest part, and that fit perfectly on the camera. If I would have used that with just a little bit of glue on the outside, would have been perfect, you know. No trying to adjust it and, you know, all the wiggling and playing around with it at the moment, you know, the glue is setting. That was nerve-wracking. But again, if you try this at home yourselves, good luck. I personally am very satisfied with it. I think the way that it's set up now, it can actually, I don't need the smaller of the two pieces. I can actually just use the big one, and that would work best when it, you know, bolting onto other rifles it with different scopes. It doesn't necessarily have to be a rifle with a Hawke scope. I have some rubber pieces that I can put onto the scopes to protect them from the tightening of the screws.
We are at the last phase of constructing the scope mount. As you can see, the hole's been drilled out. I've added some bolts. And the tactical sunshade from UTG 40mm has arrived. Might be actually a little bit bigger than what I needed. The overall diameter of this thing is about 51-52mm. The 40mm is actually in here, this inside diameter. Because this outside diameter, if you can tell, it's about 42. So now, it's obvious I can't take this part, the part that's going to screw onto the scope, can't take that on the 50mm side because way too big, right? Have to glue it on this side. And that's the next step. It's gluing this part together and gluing this ring together. This ring goes on that camera. And actually, that's the most nerve-wracking part of this construction that I have, is using JB Weld to glue this ring on there. That's the view through the scope cam. As you can see, it holds on there pretty tight. Have really no big complaints. Well, there we go. They're set. Now it's just a matter of waiting again. Probably overnight. Make sure it sets properly, cures fully.